What are we analyzing, her?
An aberration in the expected timeline for this organic being has occurred. Behold, the body of Maria Keen, formerly the constable of the Eridanos atmospheric complex.
Oh, that's a constable.
No signs of life detected. Maria Keen is survived by no known relatives.
That's Constable Keen. These are small wounds. She looks like she was shot in the head and neck.
Excellent observation, Inspector. Multiple wounds located in the frontal bone and between the clavicles suggest she was facing away from her attacker. Furthermore, the location and circumference of exit wounds suggest a firearm with unconventional ammunition.
Unconventional ammunition. I noticed some casings on the ground. Ammunition?
These casings are too minuscule for conventional small-caliber firearms. Each casing resembles a lancing needle used for medical and surgical purposes.
Could it be the needler? Medical purposes? Amplifier, scan her blood for toxins.
High concentration of potassium chloride detected. Trace amounts of neurotoxin detected.
Potassium chloride. That would have stopped her heart.
These substances show the highest concentration near the entry and exit wounds. Cardiac arrest, rather than physical trauma, is the most likely cause of death.
Seen enough. Well, we have the key card now. Rest in peace. Now we don't have to hack it. Which we couldn't even do anyway. Purveyor Spaceport, Constabulary Terminal. Unauthorized use of this terminal is punishable by a monetary fine or indentured labor in the cantina kitchen. Anyway. Internment logs. Mills Cassidy. Cause of arrest? Suspected smuggling. Arrest log. Suspicion of smuggling is fait accompli to any arrest report involving Cassidy Mills. Cassidy has made attempted smuggling a hobby, and with a few more years of unsupervised practice will likely elevate attempted smuggling into an art form. The key term here is attempted. I'm not at all confident in Cassidy's ability to successfully smuggle anything. She's clumsy in the extreme, obvious to a fault, and couldn't hide sand in the desert. This is funny. Suspicion of smuggling nonetheless constitutes dissident, irresponsible, or otherwise untoward behavior, contrary to the high standards of Rizzo's company law. Because Cassidy Mills falls under the purview of Sublight Underground, I expect Mr. Kincannon to pay your internment fees within 36 hours, as usual. Okay, Zuber Oza. Cause of arrest. Disorderly conduct. Mr. Oza was found semi-conscious earlier yesterday morning, lying amongst the remains of a crate of Rizzo's confectionaries. Material value 15 bits, market loss approximately 1500 bits. When approached by guards, Oza began to rave and yell, uttering phrases such as, "Rizzo's has slugs! Slugs! They'll kill us all!" Mr. Oza was apprehended and brought to the constable's office. Slug bureaucrats had begun work on the defamation papers, which, in tandem with the price of the goods Mr. Oza destroyed, will likely force him into hard labor for the rest of his life. At least they won't be stoking any trouble between us and Rizzo's anymore. Delinquent log, Alexis Lamb. Cause of arrest, public drunkenness. 6 arrests of Lamb this month. He's getting close to his record. Security Let's check the messages first. Please enter passcode. Okay, not yet. Check diagnostics. Now running diagnostics. Message system pass. Security footage archive pass. Internment logs pass. Record archives fail. Error. Record archives not found. Pursuant of Rizzo's company policy, all constabulary terminals must provide for the maintenance, archiving, and disposal of official records. Query, record archives. Accessing information on record archives, official records. Deleting record archives requires high-level clearance. Any attempt to delete official records without clearance is a punishable offense. Let's try the hack and run the data recovery. Record archive backup not found. Record archive index not found. Record archive recovery subroutine has been critically altered or damaged. Critical damage detected. Data recovery failed. Subroutine repair requires supervisor access. Please enter your supervisor clearance passcode now. I cannot do that. Security footage archive. Oh, there's nothing there. Okay. Hex 70. What if I take something? What is my hacking at? Well, I guess I already read this Dissident Queen Chapter 3. Oh. My hacking is 60. Oh! Well, if I take off the armor, I can make it 60, and then maybe... add to it. Let's see. Don't ask me why these hats help with anything, but they do. Tech skills? Does that help? No, hack is just at 60, so hack is not a tech skill, per se. Let's see, what might help? I need something that gives me plus 10. Or I need to level up and put a lot of points into hacking. Plus 1 though. Doesn't help with that. She says, if I bring someone along who's good at hacking, I gotta see what's in there. Don't give me that. Oh, I need to leave. I can't just...
I don't know if Spencer has a backbone to kill Helen, but I'd love to slap him around anyway. Just for fun.
I don't understand the obsession folks have with celebrities. People talked a lot about Spencer. A lot. Even on Monarch. Then we meet the guy and he's just... a guy. Nothing special. You ask me, folks ought to focus more on being the best version of themselves. Not the best version of some fantasy figure.
You're right. Oh wait, if I talk about something else...
Sure thing, and what's up?
You mind heading to the ship for a bit?
Oh, sure, Cap. Let me know if you want some company, if I ain't blacked out.
I can't have someone join the party unless we go back, right? Okay. Who's got the good hacking?
What's on your mind?
I don't think it's you. It might be Felix? Well, no. The priest. What's his name? The father. He's got the good hacking. It's just a matter of finding him then.
Get off the pot, damn it. Are you listening in there? You can't be hogging the facilities for 40 damn minutes. You ought to see Ellie. You got a condition or something.
Knock, knock. I need your help.
Spencer is quite the unfortunate individual, isn't he? Perfect example of where an overinflated need for importance leads. I find myself marveling at the complex simplicity of the... Something vexing you, Captain?
Oh, I gotta leave and choose him. Okay, never mind. I gotta leave and choose him. Okay, this is not where I wanted to be. Think it's him? I still have no clothes on. Well, I got a bodysuit on, but... Hacking is... effectively 104. So I can put this back on. I don't need 104, I just need... 70, I think. Alright, now that Max is with us. Alright. For unparalleled hacking expertise. Hello? Yeah. Enter passcode. The passcode is I_love_terror_on_monarch. Password accepted. Welcome, Maria Keene. Okay, from Administrator Ludovico here. Constable, I know you don't need to hear this, but please be on your guard. Piraeus Spaceport is technically outside my jurisdiction, which means you're the only representative of company law in Slug territory. Not anymore. This is more than I can reasonably expect from you, but I'd appreciate it if you kept an eye on Cedric Kincannon. He's looking for any opportunity to seize control of the entire complex from me, and you're keeping him in check. You're the first, last, and only line of defense between Slug's lawless hooligans and our project. I know you have dreams of something bigger than Eridanos, never to be accomplished. If this product launch is successful, if Spectrum Brown spreads to the rest of the colony, I promise you I'll find you a place where you can be happy for the rest of your life. You're a valuable part of the Rizzo's family, and I will look after you. Quentin. Or maybe you're the one that killed her. So I can't hack this for supervisor clearance passcode? Why not? I can hack the other thing. I guess we're done in here. You do that on purpose when people leave, right? So worried about you. Step. Shooting us in the back? Spencer Woolrich, yeah. We have other stuff to do. Cassidy told you the smuggled cargo was moved to the shipping yard in the spaceport. You'll have to find more specific details on your own. Cassidy suggested looking for an employee or an inventory record to help locate the smuggled cargo. Capitalized. I wonder if down in that bar underneath the dry goods place. This guy might even know something you never know.
Welcome back.
Nope. He's gotta be tired of me cutting him off like that. I could talk to this guy again.
Hope the job's coming along well. No.
You seen those workers by the orchard?
Sublight Underground takes care of its own.
You ever wondered what would happen if you walked off the edge of their dump?
You seen those workers by the...
Hey, I think I know you. You're that inspector they hired, right?
Welcome back, pal. Can I get you something?
No. You may not. Does that attack if we start wandering around in the wrong place? Freight storage and processing. Sublight. Okay. Restricted access. We could jump over it, but we got this guy here anyway. That ladder. I wonder if we can get around the other way. I do not like those things. A marksman, huh?
We don't toss troublemakers out of airlocks. We just throw them over the edge.
That's good to know.
I'm pretty happy working for Slug. Mr. King Cannon treats us with respect.
Okay, then. That thing was right here. I didn't realize. I like to know where they are at all times. Oh, these are like robot bays. Okay. More restricted access. So many things you think would be steal, but they're just take. Buy a bunk, really.
Somehow, I don't think the freelancers and sublight agents are staying at the Grand Colonial.
Probably not. Hi.
You ever wondered what happened if you walked off the edge of Eridanos?
No.
Hey, I think I know you. You're that inspector they hired, right?
Maybe.
Hey, pal. Over here.
Hey.
Hey there. You're looking to unwind, friend? Maybe you're on your way to the bar for a good time? Maybe you're interested in something a little better than beer or Adreno? Something with a little more kick?
Cheh. He reminds me of him. What he looks like to me. And I'm now doing a quick search because I can't remember the guy's name. He looks like... Hold on. Joe Keery, who plays Steve Harrington. That's what he looks like to me. What are you selling?
The name's Oryk. I deal in, shall we say, holistic pharmaceuticals.
Okay.
Natural substances and the like. You know. Alternative stuff.
Oh?
I know. Ooh, it came out of the ground. That's where worms live. I get it. I do. Why go for that homegrown shit when you could be pumping your body full of effort accelerators? Says it right on the Anticleo's box. Better than nature, right? Well, I'm gonna let you in on a little secret, pal. Those pharmaceuticals the corporations manufacture? Not all of them are as good for you as the board wants you to believe.
Really?
Alternatives. That's the way to go, pal. Trust me. No matter what ails you, I got what you need.
What kind of alternatives do you sell?
What do I sell? I've got premium shit, my friend. Vitamins like you wouldn't believe. Calcium, vitamin D, reverse vitamin D. I got everything, my friend. You got stress problems? I got stress solutions. Aromatherapy eases the mind. Diluted mantisaur essence. Best kept secret in the business.
It's probably just ground up fast ration pills. Or it's the real thing, which is an incredibly dangerous hallucinogen that tastes disgusting.
And if you're a real freak, techniques to calm yourself by fooling your own mind. If they can tame the rage of a certain well-known tossball star, they can help anybody.
Tame the rage of Spencer Woolrich? I guess I can actually buy this stuff, but it is, more information. And all these bunks. Buy a bunk. Sublight salvage and shipping underground. Buy a bunk terminal. Tired of sleeping on a ship? Is the Grand Colonial $2,000 for your bit cartridge? Enjoy moderate luxury. Buy a bunk. Waiver? Sublight salvage and shipping underground is not responsible for any damage incurred by you while you rent this unit. Slug does not guarantee the condition of this unit or any amenities therein. Slug does not guarantee that this unit is vermin-free. The corpses of any vermin killed by the user, intentionally or otherwise, are the property of Slug. Removal of said corpses will be met with a fine of no less than 1,000 bits. By agreeing to rent this unit, you waive any right to pursue Slug for damages. Alright, before I rent the unit, I guess so we can look around in there? See if there might be anything worth having, or look for evidence. Because then we rent... There's at least six of them, right? Rent unit. This unit is currently occupied. Oh, well that one's easy. What about this one? Enjoy moderate luxury. That one's occupied as well. Real pigsty. Moderate indeed. Algae lager? Ugh. Surprisingly, not much in these units. Maybe one of them will hold a surprising secret. I don't know. Whoa! Easy there, partner. Here's number 5. Occupied. In full view of these people. Should I really be picking? So I guess all these people occupying these units are like gone off to work or something. I don't know. I can like almost read what that says. This sound like it said asshole. How many bits do we have? Oh, way over 22,000. Yeah, I'll rent it. 1,000 bits. Bits deducted. Dispensing key. Buy-A-Bunk key card. A key card for a Buy-A-Bunk in the Piraeus spaceport. It looks like it's seen better days. Like a damaged key card? Slug worker identity cartridge. I rented it, fair and square. I got an identity cartridge for slug worker. So that's might let us in somewhere. An ID cartridge belonging to a sublight underground worker. The holographic shroud developed by this can let us through those areas. The holographic shroud developed by Phineas Wells uses the biometric information stored on a corporate identity cartridge to construct a crude holographic disguise. You cannot appear as a specific individual, but will pass as a corporate employee from a distance. Right. I know there was a reason I was going into all these things. Pardon me. Occupied. Keep waiting to see if I'll actually run into anybody in one of these places. Occupied as well. They either don't see me or they don't care. Oh, darts? Not that much in here. Shipping yard. Security. Oh, hello? What am I doing?
Slug's got a cozy operation here, but I like the groundbreaker. Smells like home, you know?
Yeah. Just bathrooms. This is where I came in, right? Yeah. Benton Chan. This looks promising. Come on in here. I'm gonna access some stuff. Don't come in here. What? Hell do you want? Get away from me. Oh! Look at that. We can get around the fence. I want to read that terminal. Just not sure if he'd react negatively to it. Like a door. Is this security? There was security around here. Whoop! I mean, that is security. Okay. This is. Close this. Spaceport Security Protocol Checklist. 1. Wait for docking procedures to finish, including ship captain wiring their docking fee. 2. Greet the captain of the dock ship and request their docking fee. If repeat visitor, charge double the docking fee. Will not be contacted in advance. That's nice. 3. Retrieve cargo manifest. Charge a flat percentile-based tariff on each piece of cargo. Charge double if captain was surly. 4. If captain complains for any reason, call slug fixers. 5. Offer cargo insurance for a 5,000-bit fee. If captain declines, notify slug fixers to rearrange their cargo later. 6. Retrieve... That's so... backhanded. I mean, what is I shouldn't be surprised, though. 6. Retrieve loading mechanicals to move cargo to shipping yards. 7. Open and inspect cargo. Anything not mentioned in cargo manifest, including stowaway vermin or additional cargo, imparts a 2,000-bit fine per pound of cargo / individual animal found. 8. If no additional unmentioned cargo is found, plant your own. Wonderful. I can't. I am standing on it. Okay. Oh, wait. Done. Greetings.
I'm pretty happy working for Slug. Mr. Kincannon treats us with respect.
Well, if he pay you good, that'd be even better. He went over here. Does he come right in? Hacking skill too low, still. Even with him with me. Body attributes. I think we want mind attributes. Wait. Not equip. Use. Really? One too low? I can take the armor off. That's right. Forgot about that.